Hey, this is Renee, and welcome to my own little world. It's January, it's a new year, and happy new year, by the way. I noticed that I didn't say it in my last video, but I still wish you a very happy and healthy new year, of course, and stay safe. But let's get back to the actual video, because it's January, I am going to do another journal setup. And I've used my transparent PVC journals like for half a year. And for this journal setup, I decided to use my holographic one because I am going to use a lot of pinks for my color scheme. And I thought that it would suit the whole vibe well. And as you can see, I already pre-cut some different pictures that I found on Pinterest. And here I am just organizing them a bit and going over them to see which one I chose out. And I wanted to kind of make a selection of things that I would like to incorporate in this front and back cover that I'm going to be making in this video. With the last journal setup that I did, I decided to put my ultimate favorite K-pop groups on my front and back cover. This time I decided to add even more artists, and I also added some solo artists as well. I added Zico, I added IU, I already went with BTS and Dreamcatcher, of course. Those are my ultimate favorite K-pop groups as of now. I added the group ACE, who is a very underrated K-pop group. I talked about them in my latest video as well. And I also have been listening to BB's music as well lately. And I really love her style. I really love her music. She's kind of a K-hip-hop alternative Korean artist. And I love her music. She has a very great voice. And she is also... she has a very nice aesthetic in her videos and her photos. I follow her on Instagram. And therefore, I decided to also add her to the front and back cover of my new journal. And the style that I went for with this front and back cover is pretty busy. I did the same for my last journal setup. I chose a very busy style, kind of a collage style, if you could call it that. And I really liked how the last one turned out, so I wanted to do it for this journal as well. But to make it less in your face, hopefully. That was my goal at least. I decided to just go with one color, which is pink. But this time I decided to cut out a lot more pictures with my journaling style than I did with the last setup that I did. And I also made sure that every picture would overlap with each other. So here you can see BB, IU, BTS, I'm currently working on Dreamcatcher, Zico, and Ace. And honestly, I don't really know why I chose to make my front cover and back cover pink, because I normally don't really like the color pink. It's not that I hate it, but I do appreciate it, but it's not my favorite color either, because I'm not really a feminine girl, so I don't lean towards pinks and pastel-y colors and stuff like that. So this was kind of out of my comfort zone, but because I made the front cover and back cover so busy, it still fit within my vibe that I was going for, and it still fits my aesthetic, if you could call it that. And as you can see, I left some space in the middle of the page, and I did that on purpose because that's where I am going to be putting some stickers, and I'm going to write out my name, the year, and basically show that this is my journal. But first, it's time for some tea. Okay, on to the stickers. I decided to go with all three of the different styles of stickers because, I mean, it wasn't busy enough for me, I guess. I thought that it would look very playful. And I noticed that the pastel stickers that I use to write out the word journal isn't really that noticeable, but hey. Time for some more tea. And we're ready to move on to the back cover. With the back cover, I decided to keep it more simple. Well, it's still busy, but not as busy as the front cover. I mean, the front cover is basically filled to the brim. And for the back cover, I decided to just leave some space, because I also noticed that I don't really look at the back cover a lot, but I also didn't want to leave it empty, so I did make a collage onto the back cover, but I noticed that I didn't put as much effort into it as I did with the front cover, which is a lot more visible, of course. Thank you. And then it's time to punch some holes in it. And then it's time to put it in the actual journal. Time to add my keychain that I used in my last journal. And it lights up. That's cool, right? And let's show you the end result. And let's show you the back. And that's it for this video. I hope you liked this video. Stay hydrated, stay tuned, and until my next video. Bye!